Good morning. Welcome to today's lecture. I will be taking you through a quick tour on FST 204, Introduction to Food Science and Technology Study Series of the Ladoke Akintola University of Technology Open and Distance Learning Center for Agri Science Option, 200 level course material. Introduction. Food is always termed as a complex biochemical material. In this study session, you'll be exposed to the definition of food science and technology. Outline of the study. After you have studied this session, you should be able to define food science and technology in your own terms, explain the different disciplines of food science and technology, distinguish between food science and technology, cooking, home economics, nutrition and food service, and also should be able to discuss food situation and regulation in Nigeria. What is food science? Food science is the study of the physical, biological, including microbiological and chemical makeup of food. The two main areas are the food chemistry and the food microbiology. Food chemistry, this involves the composition of the food, their properties, and how they react with each other in the environment. It also includes the food analysis, which is divided into two. We have the quantitative and the qualitative analysis. Under food microbiology, we have microorganisms that affect or poison food. These are subdivided into two. We have the bacteria and the fungi. Fungi can subdivide into two also. Then we have the yeast and the mold. Now we move to food situation and regulation in Nigeria. Food situation and regulation in Nigeria. We have Nigeria being a large producer of raw food, which is seasonal. During the period of harvest, a first impression of surplus is given. However, within a short time, they are exhausted through direct consumption, wastage and deterioration. Also, some are destroyed through spoilage microorganisms. This is also more because we don't have adequate processing and preservation facilities during the period of plenty. In a sharp contrast, constant food supply is ensured by extra seasonal conservation and storage of food products in developed countries. In Nigeria, where these facilities are not present, food consumption and industrial production patterns are marked seasonal. What are the importance of these regulation bodies? Examples of these regulation bodies are NAFDAC, Standard Organization of Nigeria, and the likes. The importance is they prevent adulteration, they prevent manufacturing and processing of food under unsanitary conditions, they prevent the spread of microbial infestation, they also prevent the control and use of chemical products as additives. Also, and finally, they control awareness and sensitize the populace to the need to avoid patronizing fake and substandard products. With this, I believe you have learned one or two things. See you in the next slide. Thank you for listening.